Good evening. I'm Apostle Robert Bryan, the pastor of the Place of Healing Church, and I would like to talk to you for about 5 minutes about what the Bible has to say about justification. So let's get started with prayer and get right to it. Spirit of the living God, Lord, we thank you right now for your grace and your mercy, Lord God. We lift you up and we magnify your holy name. We pray, Heavenly Father, that you would let the words of my mouth represent the meditations of thine heart, Lord God. And we ask, Heavenly Father, that we would be guided by the unction of your Holy Spirit. Have your way, Lord God, as we lift you up in praise, discovering your word. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Justification. The biblical definition for justification is divine forensic act of God based on the work of Christ upon the cross, whereby a sinner is pronounced righteous by the incrimination of a righteous Christ. Amen. So the doctrine of justification is the central truth explaining how both Jew and Gentile can be made right before God. On the exact same basis, that being having faith in Jesus Christ is what makes it happen. And without this divine truth, without justification, there can be no unity in the body of Christ. In the Old Testament, when it was discussed, it was functioned as the scriptures of a primitive New Testament church. So one that must identify the sources in the Old Testament that gave rise to the understanding of the term justification. So you can't get to justification without understanding how the Old Testament described it. Okay. So however, a specific set of passages are set in the Old Testament that provide the clearest background of the apostolic understanding. One of these scriptures is in Exodus 23:7. And it says to stay far away from false accusation. Do not kill the innocent and the just. This means that it had a legal context, because what it was talking about is when you had to judge someone, when the people who were in charge of say, finding out whether or not a person had done something wrong, they had to be very careful and tap into God in order to judge correctly. This is a legal context. In other words, it means to acquit and justify. That is clearly a forensic or legal context of the giving of a judgment. Deuteronomy 25:1 further says, also uses the same language. It says, if there is a dispute between men and they are to go to court and the judges will hear their case. In other words, they had a court back in that day and they judged right and wrong. And they had to use justification to come to their conclusions. The Old Testament is clear. The innocent and the condemned, the condemned and the guilty, were the law of the court, is the context of terms to justify. So the law of the land determined what it meant to be justified. It is a clear render of a verdict. See, that kind of shoots down everybody saying, you can't judge me, because they did judge people under the guidance of the Lord. And so the apostles, they were convinced that the truth of justification by faith is a free and divine act of God based solely upon the exercise of faith. Paul focused this key passage regarding Adam in the Bible when it says, Adam believed the Lord and he credited to him as righteous. This is Genesis 15:6. I'm sorry, I said Adam. Abram believed the Lord and he credited to him as righteousness. This is again in Genesis 15:6. Now that is the Holman Christian Standard Bible, but the King James Version says he believed. So I came with this version because I wanted you to know that he was talking about Abraham. This passage comes, it creates and forms the central theme and the core of Paul's defense of his doctrine of justification, which is explained in Romans chapter 4. The New Testament says the conflict brought about by Judaizers' insistence upon keeping the law and circumcision forced the apostle to divine forgiveness about how any person, Jew or Gentile, can have peace with God, can have salvation. This is explained definitively in the book of Romans and the book of Galatians. And two scriptures to me that stood out was Romans 5 and 1 in the KJV. It says, therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. In other words, if it were not for Jesus Christ, we would all be in trouble. His work on the cross made him righteous, and therefore he and he alone can stand in the gap for our sins, and Jesus has the right to look upon us as righteous. So we, being sinners, are made righteous because of his righteousness. It's nothing that we did. And so this kind of changed the game because Jesus is now the one and only judge. But we still judge moral character. I just don't believe there's any way we can get around that because we have to judge right and wrong. Okay. And Galatians 2 and 4 says this, and that because of false brethren unawares brought in who came in privily to spy out our liberty, which we have in Jesus Christ, that they might bring us into bondage. And so here in Galatians, Paul is simply saying, talking about false brethren trying to return us to the law when the law no longer applies. We live under grace. And so finally, what I'd like you to understand is that we are all subject to sin, meaning we don't always get it right. And we can really never be justified. We will live not in perfection until Jesus Christ returns. So how do we qualify while we're yet living to receive Christ's righteousness, to receive his justification? It is simple. Faith and obedience. We have to have the faith that God can keep us, that God can keep us obedient to his word, and that God understands that temptation can and will always come to tempt us, and that we will not always get it right. So he does not have a problem with that. He covers us in it. He sends his Holy Spirit to convict us and change the way we think. But he has a major problem with willful disobedience. You don't just get to do what you know you're not supposed to do and then run around and ask for forgiveness and turn around and go do it all over again. That's not how this works. So failing to temptation does not cause God a problem, but failing to willful disobedience will cause him a problem. You want justification, trust and have faith in the Lord that he will keep you obedient to his word. This has been my 5 minutes. God bless you and have a great night.